بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, I'm outside here at my dad's place. Subhanallah, the weather has become so much warmer, and as you can see, the snow is gone. And alhamdulillah, it's a really nice springtime evening here. And I wanted to make a little video about Ramadan that has just ended, and to give myself and to you some advice about how we can, inshallah, make sure that we don't lose the gains that we have made during Ramadan. So of course, I believe that all of us have, you know, done some extra ibadah, some extra worship during Ramadan, whether it's been praying a little bit more, either the qiyam or some sunnah prayers, whether it's been reading the Quran, or just the fasting itself has been something that we don't normally do. And subhanallah, I really do believe that Ramadan should always be like something that has also like impact on us after it has ended, so that we don't go back to the same habits, like bad habits I'm talking about, and then we don't also lose that level of worship like altogether, or at least we don't go back to where, you know, we started during Ramadan. So for example, let's say you start from here, you know, in the beginning of Ramadan you started here, and alhamdulillah, you went up a little bit, you started praying more, you did some tarawih, some qiyam, you were fasting every single day obviously, and some other extra worship, maybe you read the Quran. So let's say you went up here, so compared to where you started and compared to where you ended, there's a gap here. So what you don't want to do is to lose all that gain, all that, you know, extra worship that you have been able to do during Ramadan. And it's natural if it goes down a little bit, because you won't be praying tarawih and qiyam the same way as you were in Ramadan, obviously. You won't be fasting every day, so it's going to go down a little. But what you don't want to happen is that it goes back to the same level, or even, you know, worse, it goes even further down than where you started from. So you want to make sure that you keep some type of worship. If you were fasting every day, so now we have also the Shawwal, the month of Shawwal, and it's encouraged to fast 6 days. And if we do that, if we fast 6 days during Shawwal, we're gonna get the reward of fasting the whole year, according to the hadith by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So let's maybe try to do that at least if we can. And after fasting 30 days, every single day, then subhanAllah, it's easy. It's much easier now to pick up some extra fasting days, whether you want to do it like maybe Mondays or Thursdays, or just, you know, sometimes you try to have one day, 2 days where you fast during the coming months as well. And the same goes with the Quran. SubhanAllah, sometimes like what happens, may Allah forgive us all, is that we read the Quran in Ramadan, alhamdulillah, but once Ramadan is over, we put it somewhere high on the shelf and we only pick it up like rarely, or maybe it's just gonna stay there until the next Ramadan. And this is something we all want to avoid. So let's say you had the habit of reading the Quran daily in Ramadan. Maybe you read a lot, maybe you read 10 pages, 20 pages, maybe you really try to finish a juz every day. So if you can't keep that up, then at least make sure that you will have a small portion that you read daily, even if it's one single page. Remember, we did this one page a day Quran reading challenge in January. So at least try to keep that up. And by the way, if anyone is watching that hasn't done the challenge yet, this challenge is still up there as a playlist on my channel, and you can do it anytime. Even if you, for example, lose the gains that you made with the Quran during the challenges, you can always go back to that and start over from day one. And the same goes with any other act of worship that maybe you increased during Ramadan. Don't let let this all go to waste, like this habit that you have developed in regarding the worship, some extra worship. Don't let it go to waste now when Ramadan is over. And maybe even more importantly so, regarding some bad habits that you were maybe able to quit during Ramadan, you don't want to go back to those. So make sure you don't fall back into that, because you don't want to be like for example this Ramadan you went up here, and then after it ends you go back down here, and every year it's the same thing. What you want to do is that every year, like, you end Ramadan and you're a little bit higher than before, next year, so you always improve yourself and you get better, and in the end of the day it's about becoming a better Muslim than you were yesterday, than you were last week, than you were last month, last year. It's not really so much about, you know, competing with other Muslims. You see, mashallah, this is a hafidh of the Quran. He's reading like a juz every day throughout the year, and maybe he's doing qiyam every single night. And you know, you don't want to compare yourself with, you know, someone like that straight away. What you want to compare yourself with is mostly yourself yesterday. If you're doing just something more, something better today, then alhamdulillah, you know, this is a good sign. And this is my little my thoughts about the Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, it's been a good one for me. Alhamdulillah, I hope also for you it has been a good one. And I ask Allah to help us keep up some of the gains, at least, that we have made during this holy month. And may Allah make it easy for us. May Allah bless you. And inshallah, see you in the next video. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.